Now the next type of counter is 2-bit ripple down counter. It is again a synchronous counter which is having different clock pulses given to the system. So it is the type of ripple counter. Down counter means it will count the number or bits in terms of decreasing in order, means higher number to lower number. For example, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. In this manner, it will count the number of pulses. Whatever we get the output in terms of these outputs of these two flip-flop, the combination or set of this binary number is nothing but our digital, that digit. For example, 3, 2, 1 and 0. So now you can consider here again, similar to previous part, two flip-flops, means a JK flip-flop I have connected in such a manner that first flip-flop is given with the separate clock pulses, whereas second flip-flop is connected as a clock pulses. The output of first flip-flop is connected to the second flip-flop and it will consider as a clock to the second flip-flop, whereas the inputs of J and K of both flip-flops are connected to the high signals, means 1 and 1. For this operation of counter, we are not bothering about the inputs given. We have to consider only the number of cycles, because counter counts only the number of clock pulses applied to the system. It doesn't consider what input I am giving here through the J and K. It only counts the number of gate pulses given to the system. Here again, the operation of this counter depends on the toggling mode of the flip-flops. Toggling mode here means nothing but the operation of state means 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. In this manner it will operate, but alternately triggering of these two flip-flops. Now see how actually it works. These are the two flip-flops. I am giving the inputs as a high signal to J and K. Now first of all, consider these clock pulses. Initially I am not considering the clock pulses given to the system, means clock is absent, clock is not connected to the system on this diagram. Now, what will be the output? Output will be Q2 and Q1 becomes 0. Here you can see first output Q1 represent the LSB bit of the binary number, whereas Q2 represent the MSB bit of the binary number. Now, we have to see the operation. For applying first cycle, if I apply this first clock cycle to the flip-flop first, what actually the output will convert? This one first clock cycle can make this first flip-flop in a triggering mode. So it will convert into, or it will transform into toggling mode. Whatever the bit is present, it will convert into 0 or 1. Let us see what actually happens. Suppose for first clock cycle 1 is applied here, then initially Q1 was 0. Q1 was 0. It will convert into 1, because here toggling mode operated, so it becomes 0 to 1. Now so this Q1 is connected to the next flip-flop as a clock pulse. So Q1 is directly applied to here. So what is Q1? 1. So it is given to this one. So clock is present here. So what it happens here, this second flip-flop is again get triggered. So it becomes 1. Okay. So now second. Now for second clock pulse, second rising pulse of that clock, if I am applying to the first flip-flop, you can see Q1 was previous in a one state condition. So it is having one stored condition. So it will get triggered or toggled and becomes 0. Okay, so this 0 is connected here. So second flip-flop taking output clock, or sorry, input clock as a 0. So second flip-flop is not going to trigger. So it remains in the previous condition. So what was the previous? 1. So it becomes again, it remains as it is a 1. We will get here MSB as a Q2 1. Now next, for third clock cycle, for third positive rising cycle, it is applied to the first flip-flop, Q1 becomes triggered, this first flip-flop get triggered, Q1 becomes in a toggling mode operation. So what was the Q1? It was 0. So it becomes 1. So now 1 is given to the clock pulse. So what happens if the clock pulse is present? That flip-flop get triggered and operate in a toggle mode operation. So 1 I am giving here. So what it converts? It will change the previous condition. So 1 was there in the previous condition. It will give 0. Are you getting? So 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. If that particular flip-flop get toggle or triggered when the gate pulse is present, means one signal as an input to that flip-flop that flip-flop get triggered and operate in the toggle mode operation. Then only it changes the 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. So I'll get here 0 and 1. Now next, last fourth cycle, if I'm applying to the first flip-flop, see the previous condition of this cube 1. What was the cube 1? 1. So it becomes 0 because I am applying here gate pulse. So it becomes 0. Now this 0 is applied to second flip-flop. If clock is not present, means 0 condition state, that second flip-flop is not going to trigger. It remains in the previous condition. What was the previous? It was 0. It was in a 0. Now if you see the table, you can see the numbers here. Whatever I am getting, that output will be in terms of LSB and MSB in the 2 bits, because we are discussing here all about these counters considering only 2 bits. So whatever output I am getting, that is having only 2 bits, means 2 digits. So that will be MSB and LSB. Q2 becomes MSB, Q1 becomes LSB. So if I consider this number, you can represent this number. So 00 means 0, 11 means 3, 10 means 2, 01 means 1, and 00 means 0. In this manner, we will get output or counter in a down manner, means a decreasing manner. For example, 0, 3, 2, 1, 0. Again, if I repeat the next cycle, fifth cycle, again you will get third, then 2, and then 1. In this manner, it will operate. It will only count the number of pulses present during the operation of the counter. So this is all about the up counter and down counter. This both counter works only on the basis, or only basic thing is that JK flip-flop toggling mode, which operates or which alternately gets triggered so that we will get the toggling mode 1 and 0 and 0 and 1, so that I will get the count up and count down through the counter. This is all about the up and down counter for 2 bits.